So on a regular basis, they have authority to speak into my life to make sure that I'm on the right track. And I label them as mentors because these are four men that I look up to, I have a tremendous amount of respect for, and they take time out of their month to pour into me what it is they've already learned.
And a big welcome back to the Ask Bo Parrish Show. Alongside Bo Parrish, I'm Dave Erickson. And great topic today, and I think a lot of us can find benefit in this, has to do with mentors or mentorship. The question is, what are the advantages of working with a mentor, Bo, and where should I look for one?
Dave, that is a fantastic question. And if you think about the essence of a mentor, it's simply someone that's further down the path of life that you are desiring to travel. And this can be not just related to business. It can be in personal matters. It can be in athletic matters. Anything that we have a desire in and of that's greater than ourselves, where we are currently, there chances are there's someone in our immediate circle that we could very easily make a mentor. So there's an art of turning a friend or even an acquaintance into a mentor, because a mentor-mentee relationship is about give and it's about take. So when you're taking, you're asking someone who you would like to be a mentor to take time out of their day, out of their week, out of their month, and to pour into you. Now, there are certainly some benefits to the mentor as well, because what do we know about learning? The best way to learn is to teach. And teaching is a collection of life experience where ultimately we are deriving the most joy, the most benefit when we are learning by doing, and then once we have a grasp on the subject at hand, we are simply turning around and sharing, hence the value of a mentor. Dave, I have for myself what I call a personal board of directors. These are four men that I have single-handedly selected over the last 10 years from various walks of life. One of them is in the commercial real estate business. One of them is an entrepreneur. Another one runs a church. And these are men that I meet with on a regular basis. And they inspire me, they hold me accountable, but ultimately they bring me to test the direction in which I'm currently headed. So on a regular basis, they have authority to speak into my life, to make sure that I'm on the right track. And I label them as mentors because these are four men that I look up to, I have a tremendous amount of respect for, and they take time out of their month to pour into me what it is they've already learned.
I found some interesting statistics behind this. Employees who received mentoring were promoted 5 times more often than people who did not have mentors. And one thing I find interesting, you gave a variety of backgrounds to your personal board of directors, and those different backgrounds can add great benefit and value to your life because they bring different experiences. And another, here's an example, Richard Burton, the actor, was a mentor to Sir Anthony Hopkins. Bobby Orr, Hall of Fame hockey player, mentor to Dr. Robert Thirsk. He's an astronaut, physician, engineer, and scientist. These different backgrounds can bring a variety of skills and experience to someone else's life.
Absolutely. And if you think about the diversity at which these relationships that you just mentioned bring, these aren't necessarily pairs that you would put together, yet they gravitated to one another. And as a result, both of their skill sets were fast forwarded because of the relationship that existed. You know, I love the quote that you first mentioned about employees who had mentors. Well, you think about what a mentor is, and we already mentioned, in essence, it's someone that's further down the road of life that you're currently headed. Well, an employee who simply surrounds themselves with their peers, who are of similar skill sets really has no incentive or reason to get ahead, to do more, to outperform because they're with a similar talent pool. But an employee who picks someone out, say an upper management or someone in a different division that is worked there longer, that has taken slightly a different path, by choosing to position themselves with a person like that, they are all of a sudden being forced to develop at a faster rate. Number one, because their desire is there, but number two, they are interacting frequently with someone who has more skill, who has more talent, who has more knowledge, that ultimately the goal is that that desire is going to catch up with that talent, with that skill, with that knowledge. And at that point, that development has transpired in the mentee, who then can turn around and become a mentor.
We've talked about who you can choose from and the different fields and what skills they can provide. What do you say to that potential mentor? What's the questioning? What do you say, like, "Hey, would you mind being my mentor?" How do you engage that conversation? Because if you personally pick them, you find that you respect them, you value them. But what's the words? What do you say to them?
So I think the way that I personally have done it, which I was actually instructed to do, is to approach a potential mentor with the idea of gaining advice. And so, Dave, let's just say in the context of our relationship and your digital marketing expertise, I wished for you to be a mentor, which unofficially you are. I would say, Dave, I really want to become a fraction of the digital marketing guru that you are. Do you think that's a good idea? So first of all, I would ask, I want to become a semblance of your greatness. That's essentially what I'm saying. So I'm paying you a compliment in that first question, and then I'm asking for your validation by saying, do you think that's a good idea? And I'm guessing you're going to say yes. And my next question to you would be, well, if you were me, knowing what you know about the digital marketing world, how would you approach you about becoming a mentor? So then I put the question back on you. If you were me, how would you approach you? And then, number one, I paid you a compliment. Number two, I'm asking for your advice, and you're going to think about that. And you're going to ponder the 20 plus years of experience you've had in the media world and everything that you've learned, and you're going to reflect back in response to me on the most appropriate way to ask you. And because it becomes your advice, you're going to become committed to its success.
What kind of routine, what kind of schedule would you want to be on with someone, and how long would those sessions be? Like, is it every 3 or 4 months?
Sure. No, I would say an hour a month.
Okay, an hour a month,
An hour
and
a month is the right balance.
to make sure that time is well spent, there's got to be some preparation on your part, whether it's writing down the
Absolutely.
questions, here's my objectives for our meeting.
So here's another thing that I've learned about respecting the time of your mentor is that behind every single hour, you develop an agenda. And the way that you say it is no agenda, no attenda. Just as a little rolling off your tongue. In other words, if you do not have an agenda prepared, don't expect your mentor to attend. No agenda, no attenda.
Well, I think we just scratched the surface. This could be a long talk in the future, but thank you very much. If you had a question for Bo, use the hashtag AskBoParrish on Twitter, Facebook, or YouTube. Bo, great stuff, and thanks very much for sharing.
My pleasure, Dave.